In this video, you will learn how to solve for x in this exponential equation. Now, if you're given this value, this exponential equation, and asked to find the value of x, all we simply need to do is to simply see how we can reduce the value on the right-hand side to be equal to 1. That way, we'll be able to have a quadratic equation which we can be able to solve to get the values of x. Now let's try that. To solve this, we are going to divide all through by the value of 4 to the power of x. So if we do that, we'll have 1 to the power of x divided by 4 to the power of x plus 2 to the power of x divided by 4 to the power of x, and this will be equal to 4 to the power of x divided by 4 to the power of x. Good. Now, having done that, you'll come to see that the right hand side will be equal to 1. So over here, we'll have 1 divided by 4 all to the power of x. Reminding you of the principle of indices, that if you have a divided by b all to the power of x, this can be equal to a to the power of x divided by b to the power of x. So this will now give us plus 2 divided by 4 all to the power of the exponent x, and this will be equal to 1. Good. Now, having done this, you can come to see that this variable can give us 1 divided by 2. Good. So all we need to do is, over here we'll have 1 divided by 2 to the power of 2, right? And this will be to the power of x plus, this will divide this to give us 1 divided by 2, right? X to the power of x, and this will be equal to 1. Now, 1 square is still equal to 1, right? So if we have 1 square over here, this can be 1 divided by 2 all squared and all to an external exponent of x plus, and this would be 1 divided by 2 all to the power of x, and this would be equal to 1. Fine. Now let's simplify this equation further. To simplify this equation further, I want us to recall a law of indices. If we have a to the power of x multiplied by y, this can be equal to a to the power of y. It can also be multiplied by the exponent of x. So if we apply that over here, we'll have that equation to now give us, we'll have 1 divided by 2 all to the power of x, and all will be to the power of 2, and this would be plus 1 divided by 2 all to the power of x, and this would be equal to 1. Now let's analyze this. If we analyze this, I want us to look at having this value of let's make a 1 divided by 2 to the power of x to be equal to y. Now if we look at that, this can also give us 1 divided by 2 to the power of x all to the power of 2 can be equal to y squared. So this will now make that equation to now become y squared plus y equal to 1. Now let's subtract 1 from both sides. We are going to have 1 square plus y minus 1 equal to, subtract 1 from the right hand side, we'll have the right hand side to become 0. So that has given us a quadratic equation. So what we'll do now is to solve this quadratic equation for the value of y. To solve for the value of y, we are going to use the quadratic formula, and that will give us negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all divided by 2 multiplied by a. Now from that expression, our a is equal to 1, our b will be equal to positive 1, 2, and then our c will be equal to negative 1. So let's substitute it into that equation formula in order to get the value of y. So that will give us negative 1 plus or minus square root of, this is going to give us 1 square minus 4 multiplied by 1 multiplied by negative 1, all will be divided by 2 times 1, which is equal to 2. So for simplify that equation, we're going to have our y to now become equal to negative 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 4, right? Because negative times negative is going to give us a positive. So 4 times 1 will give us a 4. So this will be divided by 2. So our y will be equal to negative 1 plus or minus square root of 5 divided by 2, right? So the value of y will now give us, our y will be equal to negative 1 plus square root of 5 divided by 2, and we're also going to have negative 1 minus square root of 5 divided by what? 2. So those are the two solutions we are going to have for y. Now recall that we said y is equal to 1 divided by 2 all to the power of x, right? So we are going to find the value of x. If we find the value of x, we are going to have the first side of the equation to give us 1 divided by 2 all to the power of x to be equal to square root of 5 minus 1 divided by 2. I've not changed anything because from this expression, y is equal to the root of 5 is a positive. So this will give us, and we'll have 1 divided by 2 multiplied by the power of x, and this will be equal to a negative 1 minus negative root of 5 divided by 2. Now let's focus on the right hand side of these two solutions. From the right hand side, for every value of x which is equal to 1, 2, 3, be it positive or negative, this equation, the right hand side is going to give us a positive value. So while on the left hand side, we'll always have a negative value. So mathematically, positive can never be equal to negative. So as a result of that, we're going to neglect this solution, this part of the solution. So let's work with this. From this part, we're going to take the log of both sides. So if we take the log of both sides, we can also take the natural log of both sides. So if we take the natural log of both sides, this will be equal to the log of root 5 minus 1 divided by 2. So from the log of logarithm, the laws of logarithm, from the laws of logarithm, this will come over here because if we have the log of m base x, this can be equal to m log x. So that expression will now give us x log of half 1 divided by 2. This will be equal to the log of root 5 minus 1 divided by 2. Now recall that from the laws of logarithm, if we have the log of a divided by b according to the divisional law of logarithm. This will give us log of a minus log of what? Of b. So this expression will now give us, if we divide both sides by 1 divided by 2, we'll have our log x log of 1 divided by 2 divided by log of half, right? This will be equal to log of root 5 minus 1 divided by 2, all divided by the log of half. So from the left hand side, our value for x will be equal to the log of root 5 minus 1, right, minus log of 2, all divided by the log of 1 minus the log of 2. So at this point, I want to give you a serious task. I want you to find the value of x when you simplify this. All you need to do is simplify the root of 5 minus 1. The value you get, you find the log of that value, and then find the log of 2. The log of 1 will definitely give you 0. So if you simplify it, get your solution, and be sure to drop your solution in the comment section. And I will be so glad to engage with you from there. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues. And also, subscribe to our channel for more simplified mathematics solutions. Thanks so much for watching once more. And bye-bye for now.